Now, I'll make a simple statement. Just internalize them. Because yesterday's satsang, I was giving more like a hints. The Upanishads are more like a hint. Only the conclusions, punchline. I am putting it now, along with the punchlines, the connecting thread. Sutre manigana iva. Length, breadth, depth is the known dimensions of the universe. Even as per the modern day scientists, time and space is kind of a half known, yet to be explored, yet to be fully known, still remains mysterious for the grasp of ordinary human minds. But the length, breadth, depth is most comfortably, conveniently, at least understood dimensions of the known reality, world. I am developing the special super brain where my Gurukul kids, just like the scientists, are able to decode, reveal everything related to length, breadth, depth. My kids will reveal everything related to time and space. That is why I insist on them not eating outside food. Understand? See, the Gurukul food, Adinam food, the food is offered to deities, which are literally living Archavatara, gods. This is another one technique. My gurus used to use. They will insist that I eat the food offered in the temple, Arunachaleshwara temple, which was offered to Paramashiva. And Kuppamal used to do regular puja abhishekams whenever I am getting trained into some new initiation, which will be always, at least once a week. Once a week, they will do some new initiation process on me, training. Sometimes they will tell me directly, hey, this is not required for you, but you need to learn the procedure so you can train others. You can revive it. Sometimes due to my laziness, I'll try to throw tantrum to Vitaki Swami. Oh, you know Nirahara Samyama. Why are you forcing me to go and learn from Malayuchi Narayana Swami? We had one Swami who used to be sitting on the top of the hill. To meet him, I have to walk almost. For quite a long time, he was sitting inside the temple itself. Terkukattai Gopuram, the western tower. Inside Tirumanjana Gopuram, he used to be sitting. And after some time, he started staying in top of the hill. So Isaki Swami will insist, Kuppamal will insist that I go there to have his darshan. It's almost like 2 hours or 3 hours walking up and then down. When I asked him, oh, you know the science, why don't you teach? Why are you asking me to go there? He used to smile and say, you should not disrespect. Whatever is said and done, his expertise in that field and the intensity with which he can just transmit it into your biomemory is unique. So you just go and do what I'm. He used to give an example. In Thiruvannamalai, we used to have shops, that village shop. தமிழ் வில் டெல். அடே மளிகை கடையிலும் என்ன கிடைக்கும்டா, அப்புறம் ஏண்டா கிருஷ்ணமூர்த்தி மாமா என்ன கிடைக்கு தனியா போற. ஒன் பர்சன் கிருஷ்ணமூர்த்தி யூஸ் டு ஹாவ் ஷாப் ஒன்லி ஃபார் ஆயில். Sekki Swami used to say, in regular grocery shop also you get oil, but why do you go specially to his shop? Because he himself has all the complete infrastructure needed to make the oil, and he does it very sincerely, organically, and he sells only oil. He'll give this an example and tell me, go and learn. I also wanted to tell all of you, always eat only consecrated food. Eat only prasada. Eat only once a day. Make that as a lifestyle. Kanchipuram idli, as I said. I can add some 25 variety of sacred food. Kanchipuram idli, Melakotta puliyodara, Srivilliputtur akkara vadisal, Tiruppathi laddu, Jagannathar mahaprasadam. All this, just have the recipe, cook any one of this, offer to deity and eat only once a day. It's all amazing traditional food recipe. Understand,